Hi friends, in this series we have got one more video, once again very much testable topic. And yes, what I'm expecting is that you write some more topics for which you want videos, because your encouragement means a lot. Okay, now third topic is about deductible provisions. You have at least one question on this concept in examination. I've got so many things written on my website also. But yes, video is a different experience. A deductible is that portion of the amount of an insured loss which the insured agrees to pay. This is common in almost all the types of insurance policies to stipulate a defined amount of money which is to be borne by the insured, not applicable to life insurance. The insurer becomes liable for any amount beyond the deductible amount stated in the contract. Once again, I read the entire para, but not understandable. Just simply understand, like, you must be renewing your two-wheeler, four-wheeler policies online. You must have come across that there is a concept they call deductible, which says that if there is some loss amount, right, or say you have got insured declared value for your vehicle, and now they are asking you to set your deductible. If you are increasing this number, definitely you can see impact on premium. So I say it is a kind of co-insurance between you and insurance company, wherein you are suggesting insurance company that from the total claim amount, this is the amount which I'll bear, and anything above that you should pay or you bear. So deductible may be either compulsory or voluntary. Voluntary deductibles will fetch a discount in premium, also known as excess. Straight deductibles, the simplest yet most effective type, apply to all types of policies and involve subtracting the deductible amount from the aggregate loss to determine the loss payment. I'll come to it. We have got an example also. And another is franchise deductible, is expressed as a percentage of total value of the property. The liability of insurer arises in the loss amount, if the loss amount exceeds this amount. Once again, why insurance company keep all these provisions? They want you to come to them only if there is a major loss. For smaller losses, it should be simply on the insured. It should be on you. So is the reason they are assuring to pay you bigger losses. And smaller losses are to be borne by you. So to ensure that concept, they keep different types of deductibles. Now see, this is the example. Two types of deductibles. First is excess, or say straight deductible. Another is franchise. So let us consider two policies, A and B. Policy A is subject to an excess of 5,000, wherein policy B is subject to franchise of 5,000. Keep on referring to example, considering the theory element. Now, if both the policies have claims of 4,000 and 10,000. Okay, so option one, we have kept deductible provision up to 5,000. So claim amount is 4,000, excess is a straight deductible. Since loss is not more than 5,000, insurance company pays you nothing. In franchise option also, since loss is less than 5,000, insurance company pays nothing. But the difference arises here. If the loss amount is 10,000, excess provision says that 5,000, so you will be paid amount of only 5,000. But in case of franchise provision, loss is anyway more than 5,000, they will pay you full 10,000. So this is the difference, and this is what is importantly asked in examination. Ensure that you understand these two things very, very precisely. They are almost there in our examination. So with this, we conclude our insurance series. And as I said, keep commenting, keep asking for more and more videos. Keep encouraging. Thank you so much.